Hi, I'm Doug, your tech support representative for Atlantic British, and in this video we're going to touch base on the O2 sensor replacement as part of your service and maintenance program. Now, it's recommended on the higher mileage vehicles, as actually in Land Rover's programs, you're usually recommended at 90,000 miles. So if you have a high mileage Land Rover, the Defender 90, the Discovery 1, and the P38 Range Rover will use this kit. It will give you all four sensors, your two upstream and your two downstream, which actually are the same O2 sensors. And what we're going to do later in this video is we're going to give you basics and tips on how to replace those O2s. Okay, so now we're going to show you where the location and give you a couple tips on changing the O2 sensors, and this will be a 97D90. Now, since the advent of OBD2, most of your vehicles 96 and up are going to have four O2 sensors. You're going to have two upstream ahead of the catalytic converters and two downstream behind the catalytic converters. Now, in the case on this one, these are all the same size. Now, these are going to be a 17 millimeter wrench you're going to use to take these off. And you'll see the locations on all four. Access is pretty reasonable on these. The only thing you might find a little bit is on the routing for the wiring to get to your connectors. You should be able to get to all four quite easily. But always check the routing of the wiring before you take it apart, before you take it off, so that when you install it, you're going to put your wire in the same place. Most notably, as you look at the rears, where they run the wire through the transmission mount so that they don't get hung up down below. You really want them up in a protected area, but yet not high enough to hit any of the supports or any moving linkage under there. Now, essentially, and we're going to show you on this O2 sensor right here, which is the downstream on the number 2 bank or passenger side of the vehicle. They've been in there for a while. They usually find a flare wrench is usually the best application to at least crack it loose. It has a better fit on the O2 sensor itself, will cause less distortion. That's why they use these on brake lines as well. I'm just going to slide that over. And it's angled, so it'll actually give you some access to the other end. And you just take a medium-sized ball peen hammer, and you can usually tap them loose. Now, some of these it is loose, but not quite loose enough to turn with a finger, so you can just grab a regular open-end wrench, spin it off the rest of the way, trace your wiring to the connector, which in this case is just up and over the transfer case, but still relatively easy to get at, just right up in here where my finger is. And the other side will be the same. When you do the fronts, probably your best bet is to remove the O2 sensor and then lower the vehicle, or if you're on a creeper, go back up top. Your connectors are actually fairly easy to get at behind each cylinder head up top. We're going to tighten this one back up. You don't need to tighten it with a hammer like you did to take it off. You'll feel it seat just like a spark plug. Give it a little push, eighth of a turn. Now she's seated in. Again, you don't want to over torque it and do any damage to the threads. That's pretty much your O2 sensors. As we mentioned earlier, it's recommended change them every 90,000 miles. After a period of time, they do get coated. They're not as efficient as they were when they were new. That affects your fuel mixture in your engine, which again can affect performance and fuel economy. When you want to do your O2 sensors and you're ready for the kit, you can call any of our knowledgeable salesmen at 1-800-533-2210.